Hi everyone. I'm slightly off of camera because I wanted you to see this guy laying here behind me because it actually fits in perfectly with what the emphasis on our yin practice is going to be today. If you're watching this in somewhat real time, you or probably someone in your house is having a lot of difficulty sleeping, myself included. So this practice is designed to really to help us to hopefully find a way into a more peaceful deep sleep at night. Or during the day, if you're a napper. See, Frank Sinatra here is—he's a big believer in napping and stretching. Prop-wise today, I think two blocks will be really good for you to have nearby for a couple of the poses. So I'm going to make my way over here to the mat. We'll see if Frank decides to stay with us today. So we'll start in a comfortable seated position. So just find a good seat. If you wanted to sit up on one of those blocks, this would be a great opportunity to bring that into play. Otherwise, just find you a comfortable seat. We're going to bring our palms onto our thighs or knees, going palms down to encourage a sense of groundedness in this practice. And let your eyes close. Take a deep breath in and a long exhale out of the mouth. Again, deep breath in. Big open mouth exhale. And part of the struggle that we have in getting a good sleep at night is kind of letting the mind come to rest. So the mind is probably whirling around, telling a lot of stories right now. And maybe your mind lands on one. And as you take that deep breath in, is there anything you can do about that story? If there's not, on that exhale, just put it to the side. As you let your breath start to find more of a deeper rhythm, let those shoulders drop from the ears. Let that lower jaw drop from the upper jaw. Find some space between the brows. You might even bring a fingertip there. Just kind of give yourself a little massage right there between the brows. Carrying that tension in the jaw. Find that jaw hinge. Just give yourself a little massage there. Then we're going to bring one hand down. Pick a hand, doesn't matter which one. Your pointer and your middle finger are going to turn in, so you kind of have a thumb, a mahalo situation here with your thumb and your index finger. We're going to do a little bit of alternate nostril breathing. This is a great way to calm down anytime during the day, but this is especially helpful at night. So take an inhale and exhale through the nose. Our right thumb, or a thumb rather, is going to block that right nostril. Inhale through your left nostril. Block that off, open up your right nostril, exhale through the right. Inhale through the right, block, exhale through the left. Inhale through the left, block it, exhale through the right. Inhale right, close, exhale left. Close. Sorry. Inhale left. Close. Exhale right. Two more rounds. Inhale right. Close. Exhale left. Inhale left. Close. Exhale right. Hand down. Inhale. And exhale. Yourself a little shrug in the shoulders, maybe a little bobblehead movement here. I'm going to grab my timer. Our first actual pose is going to be butterfly pose. So we're going to bring the soles of the feet together. If you have a bolster, you can put a bolster across your lap to rest on. If you don't, then I'm not practicing with any props here. We're going to start to hinge forward. You might have to reach back, kind of get a little bit of junk out of the trunk. And then if you're a little stiffer in the back, keep the spine a little longer, Frank's board. Drop your chin to your chest, round your back. He's gonna go to his preferred napping spot, I believe. That's probably your last Frank experience of the class today. Now, if you're feeling a little tighter in these hamstrings and hip flexors, don't be in such a hurry to get over. You know, give your muscles time to relax first, and then that connective tissue will open up as well. If you're stiff in the neck, maybe you kind of nod the head a few times. And then let your chin rest towards your chest. And then you might see if you can take the hands a little further, and that might help you round over a bit more. I was wrong. There's more Frank. We're only going to do about a 3-minute hold on most of these poses today, so that if you wanted to do this before bedtime, it's not going to be, you know, a very cumbersome practice. Like, you'll be able to fit it in. This is really great after like a hot shower or a hot bath. We're about halfway there on this pose. Less than a minute here. Four more breaths in this shape. Okay, so let's find a little bit of engaging of the belly. We're not going to extend the muscles very much here. We're going to relaxing influence here. Soles of the feet to the floor, and then just kind of hug around your legs here. Maybe tip your head down. That's a good hip and outer hip low back pose where we tend to hold a lot of stress, especially by the end of the day. Another spot for that is the hamstrings. So we're going to send out this right leg. We're going to do a half butterfly pose here. So sole of that left foot to the inside of that right leg. Let this leg go a little limp here. Now, if you have your blocks nearby, mine aren't terribly close, you could put them on either side of your leg and let your hands rest there, and maybe you don't round over as much. I really like to round over in this pose, so I'm gonna let my hands stay on the mat, technically on the floor. And you wanna keep encouraging this right leg to relax. Try not to flex that foot and have those toes pointed up. If they want to drop open to the right, let that happen. Check in that you're not clenching your jaw here. I find it when I practice this pose, or any pose really that deals with hamstrings, sometimes in an effort to kind of get past that tightness, I'll clench my jaw or I'll make angry eyebrows. So try not to do either of those things. Try to soften here.
about a little more than 30 more seconds on this side. So up, just very mindfully here, let's take that left leg out. One of my favorite things to do after that pose is to hold the legs out for a second, and your right leg may be a little bit longer than your left, but we're gonna do both sides, you'll be fine. So right foot to the inside of that left leg. Again, let it relax a little bit here. And we're gonna just walk the hands forward. And you wanna think more about going over this left leg than kind of inside the leg. Don't get terribly surprised or concerned if one side is maybe a little tighter than the other. There's some schools of thought in yoga that your right side is your analytical problem-solving side, and your left side is your more emotional side. So if you're dealing with an imbalance in either area, then that could explain why a pose could be different. One more minute here, a little bit more than that. Ten more seconds here. And then again, mindfully rolling up the torso. You can bring the soles of both feet to the floor here and maybe just lean back into your hands and have a little bit of a back bend. Or you could rock a little bit side to side. Your hips are like, we have to move. All right, then we're going to go over both legs. So you're going to send out the feet, legs are going to be straight, hip, maybe shoulder width apart. I would say if you feel a little tighter, go a little wider with the feet. If you feel like pretty loose in those hamstrings, you could come in a little closer. Again, you can have blocks on either side here, but not necessary. And then you're going to hinge forward. We're going to round into it. Again, we're just moving through the poses almost like a flow. Again, just because we're, you know, it's close to bedtime. I don't want you to feel like you have to, you know, commit like an hour plus to this. And I love doing these forward folds like right before bed, because if you spend a lot of time on your feet, you know, standing, or if you spend a lot of time sitting at a desk, these back muscles can get really tired and tight. And this rounding into it not only helps you to stretch the muscles, but you get that connective tissue up and down the back and the back of the neck, especially if you spend a lot of time, you know, looking at a computer or at your phone. Again, look for where you can soften in this pose. A lot of times it's going to be the muscles around the face, especially around the jaw. It could also be you hunching your shoulders to your ears. Try not to do that either. About one more minute here. If you find you're still holding on to your day, either within your body or in your muscles, or even just in your mind, some exhales through the mouth will really help you shift into that relaxation response. About 30 more seconds. We're going to roll up again. Mindful and easy are the key words here. Maybe some shrugs with those shoulders. Might roll the feet in and out a little bit. Not going too vigorous with our movement. Now we're going to do a variation on pigeon pose next. Again, kind of keeping in these hips. This is a seated version of pigeon, and it's not the double pigeon that most of us have a dislike for. I'll put it that way. It's like thread the needle that we do on the back, but we do it seated upright. A block could make things easy for you. I'm going to show you in just a moment. So we're going to start with the feet on the floor. And you're going to bring that right ankle to that left thigh. Now, if this is too much, then you could put that block at the low setting under that left foot. And it kind of dials down some of that heat for you. I'm going to go on the floor here. Let's start our timer. So lean back into your hands a little bit. So there's it's almost a hint of a back bend here. It's not a real strong back bend. And we're not going to do a hard flex in this right foot, but it's a little bit more flexed than it is neutral. And if you feel like that outer right hip or right glute are really holding on, just rock a few times side to side until you feel like you can hold this position still. Again, shoulders are going to be down the back. Your fingers are just going to point to where you feel is comfortable. You've been in this for about a minute. If you wanted to come down onto your back and hug this leg into the chest, for the last 2 minutes of the pose, you could do that. It's a little hard for me to see the timer from this position. So we'll get a little creative there. You're about halfway through. One more minute. Now, if you're seated, go ahead and uncross the legs and just bring both feet to the floor and just maybe wrap your arms around the legs. If you're on your back, uncross, give those knees a hug. Come back up to our seated position. So we're going to take that to the other side. So left ankle on right thigh. Remember, you can put a block under that right foot, and it just makes it, you know, like maybe about 10% easier for you. If you did the, went down onto your back, start here, because that's how we started on the other side. And we want to be a little symmetrical with this. You will always hear an audible sigh from me when I get to a pose on the left. It tends to be my less cooperative side. And yes, I have some emotional stuff. All right, so if you're with me, if you want to do the last 2 minutes on your back, feel free. We'll go down and just hug it in here. Almost at that halfway point. Again, if this is the side that's a little trickier for you, maybe some exhales through your mouth to help you relax into it a bit more. About 30 more seconds here. If you're seated, uncross the legs, and again, just kind of hug, or sorry, wrap your arms around the shins. If you're with me, uncross, give your knees a little squeeze. If you went onto your back, we're going to come up to a seat just for a moment. This is where blocks are going to be very helpful for the last part of class. So if you have two blocks, or if you just have something very close to the shape and size of a block, you could use that too. You're going to bring these down at the end of your mat, either on their low setting or their second setting. But before we do that, we're going to revisit that butterfly pose. So soles of the feet together, but this time we're going to lay down for about 2 minutes in a reclined butterfly pose. This is a good way to, again, let go of these outer hips, inner thighs, hip flexors. Arms could come out like little goalposts or cactus arms. So we're going to give you a little bit of a back bend there. Or you could take the arms around your head and kind of make a little picture frame holding on to opposite forearm or elbow. If either of those shapes produce a pinch or a numbness or tingling in the fingers, come out of that shape. around 30 seconds here. If you did something special with the arms, go ahead and release that and bring the arms alongside you to where your palms or just under your thighs. And then you'll need to draw your belly in a little bit. You might use the hands to help you close up those knees. And then take your feet a little bit wider than your hips. We're going to drop the knees over to the left just for about 5 breaths. Back to the center, and then we'll drop them over to the right for about 5 breaths. And we'll come back to the center. Now we're going to extend out our legs, and we're going to put our ankles or your heels up onto those 2 blocks at the end of your mat. It's just going to prop your legs up a little bit. If you have a space on a wall or you have a door that's securely closed, you could slide over and do your legs up that wall or up that door. I like to bring my palms to my belly or to my ribs. Just feel the rise and fall of my breath. A little bit of elevation in your legs, whether they're on the blocks or at the wall, is so good for the circulation of blood in your legs. Pick legs up the wall, let your feet kind of slide down the wall as you bring your knees to your chest. If you're on the blocks, just bring your feet to the floor. If you went up the wall, go ahead and roll to one side and just crawl back out on the length of your mat. If you use the blocks, you can use your feet to just kind of press them away from your mat. I'm going to take you through sort of an abbreviated yoga nidra here, which is great to also do just in bed if you find that you can't sleep. I'll show you my 2 favorite combos, my 2 favorite tricks here for if I'm having a hard time falling asleep. It's the box breath, which is just a breathing in and a retention of the breath. And then it's the yoga nidra, where we will consciously contract and release from the toes to the head. So close your eyes. Let the arms rest alongside you with palms up. I like to do it with palms up, almost in a gesture, like I'm letting just the day kind of slide between my fingers. So inhale to the count of 4. Hold for 4. Exhale for 4. Hold for 4. Again, inhale. Hold. Exhale. Hold. We're going to do that breath for about 1 more minute. If you want to deepen it, feel free.
then take a deep breath in and an open mouth exhale. Then bring your attention down to the feet. Point the toes and then flex the feet and let them soften. Flex your feet, tighten the muscles of your legs. Exhale, soften. Inhale, flex the feet, tighten the muscles of the legs. Engage the glutes, squeeze the glutes. Exhale, soften the glutes, the legs, the feet. Inhale, flex the feet, tighten the legs, squeeze the glutes, draw the belly in. Exhale, soften the belly, the glutes, the legs, the feet. Inhale, flex the feet, tighten the legs, squeeze the glutes, draw the belly in, make fist. Exhale, soften. Inhale, flex the feet, tighten the legs, squeeze the glutes, draw the belly in, make fist, tighten the muscles of the arms. Exhale, soften. Inhale, start at the feet, all the way up to fist and flexed arms. Draw the shoulders up to your ears. Exhale, soften the shoulders and everything down to the feet. Inhale, flex the feet. Tighten everything up to the shoulders, to the ears, to scrunching up the face. Squeeze the eyes, purse the lips. As you exhale, soften everything from the eyes down to the feet. One last time. Inhale, flex the feet, tighten everything all the way up. Scrunch up the face, maybe lift the head about a quarter inch off the floor. Exhale, lay the head back down, soften everything. Okay, let's do it one more time. So as you inhale, tighten everything from your feet all the way up to your head. Hold it, sip in a little more breath. Exhale, drop everything down. Feel the weight of your head on the floor. Maybe rock it a little bit side to side. Feel the muscles of the face soften. Drop the shoulders, relax the arms. Feel the weight almost leaving like an imprint on your mat, on your bed, wherever you happen to be doing this on. The efforts of the day just sliding out of your hands. I appreciate you taking time to do this practice with me today. I hope that it serves you, and I hope that it helps you to find some easeful, peaceful sleep. Until next time, namaste.